everybody, and welcome back to Organize Joy, organizing your life from A to Z. Today, we're going to talk about buying for a month versus buying for a week. This would obviously be household stuff, right? There's a place for both, and I do both. There needs to be a monthly shop for all the staples, all the things that you need that don't go off. And then there's weekly lists. Those are the things that you need each week. Bread, milk, salad, meat, etc. So we're going to talk about how you separate them, how you manage them so that you don't waste and that you don't buy things you don't need, and that you don't get to the shops without a list thinking, I need this. Turns out you had three at home and you didn't need it. But before I start, I thought I'd tell you about this little thing. This is called an ark. An ark that what you're supposed to do is fill it with a whole lot of change. An ARC stands for Acts of Random Kindness. Now, what the purpose of it is you take it, it's a little money bank, and you fill it with all your change, so it says full, and then once it's full, you share. You share it with someone who you think needs it, no matter who that is. And I've been quite involved in this project, and it's something quite special to me. So I just wanted to put it out there, because as you're buying and you end up with some change at the end of the month or at the end of the week, pop it in your little ark and yeah, give it to someone who deserves it. I will put a note in the bottom, a link to the ARC website where you can go and get your ARCs. Okay, so let's first talk about the list you need for 1 month. I should probably say here, I mean, shopping lists are technically under S and we're only on B's. But we thought that you'd need the shopping list up front, so that's why we're getting into it now. So a monthly shopping list, I've done one for you, so don't stress, but it is my monthly shopping list. I will put it on the website and you can download it. And then the best thing to do is make it yours. So take out the things that I buy every month that you don't need and add in the things that I haven't got that you need. That way you make it specifically yours. And what I do is at the end of every month, after I've done my big shop for that month, I print a new one, I put it on the fridge, and then as I go through the month and I take the last one out of the cupboard, so the last whole peeled tomatoes, for example, I tick off, I need more whole peeled tomatoes. That way you'll never run out of the things that you need. You always know what's missing from your cupboard or your pantry. And then what I also do is a couple of days before I go shopping, I run through the pantry with my list. I see what's there, what do I need. I've still got salt, I've still got sugar, I don't need those. I cross those off, so I don't need to buy them again. Then I have one list, and when I'm ready to go shopping, take it off the fridge, and off we go. Now you'll also see on the list that I've created for you, there's obviously all the things that are monthly. And then I've done a few of the other little bits and bobs that I also only buy monthly. So when I go to the pharmacy, the supplements or the vitamins that I need for that month. I love going to the Italian wholesale store, Super Sconto, and I have their list on there because I only go once a month. Sometimes I only go once every 2 months. But that way, everything that is a monthly shop is on this list. Okay, so as I mentioned up front, I have created these lists for you. Remember, they are mine and you need to edit them to include the things that you need. But what I've done is I've built it into sections to make it really easy for myself and now for you. So I've got cleaning stuff, toiletries, general stuff that goes in the freezer, normal groceries, so spices and sauces and stuff like that. Then I've got salads and meats on here for at the end of the month when we go by, we can do that weekly shop at the same time, right? Then there's dairy, there's bread, there's all my supplements and vitamins. There's everything I go to the pharmacy for. So for example, I don't have panada on the list, but if panada is important to you and you buy it every month, put that on. I've got all the things for my munchkins, my three little dogs, plus the goldfish that live in the pond, and birdseed. Then I have the nut lady, I go to her every month. I go to Super Sconto, as I said, the Italian wholesaler. And then I have various specials. Specials on here are like fish spice that I get at Fisherman's Deli, my Nespresso that I need for my fabulous coffee every morning. Then I also have a list for my housekeeper, Lizzie. I buy her certain things every month, so I have her section. And then I have a section for the body shop of all the bits and bobs that I get from them when I need it. So room sprays, hand wash, etc. So it's a full list of anything that I need in a month or could need in a month. Okay, so go and check out the list and download them at organizedjoy.co.za. They're all there. And they're editable, like I said, so make them your own. Don't forget to go get yourself a little ark. It's a really good thing to do. And doing an act of random kindness whenever you can is really, really special. There's also an app, actually. You can go and have a squiz at that. But thanks so much for joining me at Organize Joy, organizing your life from A to Z.